Hi there. Today I want to show you how you can use your bezel and incorporate into your paper crafting projects. So to begin with, I created my card base, an A2 size out of cardstock. And next I went ahead and got a coordinating pattern paper that had images on it and searched for an image that I thought would look nice inside my oval. So what I did was I cut the extra pattern paper off and I placed my oval die number one being the smallest, over top of the rose image that I wanted to use. And I taped it with repositionable tape and cut and embossed it. Then I just popped it out of the die template and I used some liquid adhesive just to give it a little extra shine. And so any liquid adhesive that you have that would dry quickly, I just smeared it with my finger, just set it aside to dry, used a little wipe to get cleaned off, and now I'm ready to create my layers on my card. So I used my Matting Basics B to create my first layer. I cut and embossed it out of cardstock and adhered it right onto my card. I love the Card Creator dies that just allow you to evenly layer up your pattern paper and your cardstock. The next layer, I used my Matting Basics A, and I cut and embossed the green cardstock. And before I adhered it on, I distressed the edges using my distressor and a little bit of ink. And then I chose a pattern paper that had some notes on it and just adhered it to the back. So then I was ready to add my adhesive and placed it right in the center of that first cardstock layer. Next, I used some pattern paper that coordinated with my oval die cut piece that I did earlier. And I used my Matting Basics A again, cut and embossed it. And again, I adhered that right to the center so that there was a nice even layer around. And for my label 17, I went ahead and I cut it out of cream cardstock, and then I cut it out of a pattern paper, and I just snipped that extra pattern paper off and layered it on top of the pattern paper. So then I had a nice clear spot where I could stamp my image, or my sentiment rather, and then I just placed a piece of lace over the seam there. So that's ready to go on. But before I put that on, I wanted to put a nice stripe pattern paper across my layers. So I cut out a strip of pattern paper from some stripes and added that across the bottom. And for this piece, I went ahead and I just used some foam squares to give it a little bit of dimension. Put those on the back and was able to layer that right into the center of the card, like so. And when I took my bling, I just cut little pieces. I used my Wanna Scrap bling that I use for everything. So I just, instead of putting it all the way across, just used a couple little pieces, and that's all that shows anyways. So put those on there like that. And by now, hopefully, your piece that you added a little glue to is dry. And what I did is just added three more foam squares to the back so that it would pop up a little bit in my bezel. And then I just placed it right into the bezel like that. And now the adhesive that I added to the top just gives it a nice little bit of shine. And on the back side, I added a piece of Scorpel tape, very sticky double-sided tape, and place it onto the trim and just give it a little push. Now that it's nice and sticky, it will stay in place there. And to finish it off, I used, again, some Wanna Scrap pearls just to put on the edge there. And these are already adhesive, so they can just pop right onto the bezel and just give them a little push in like that, and then they'll be ready to stay in place. Then I tied my bow and added a little foam dot to that, stuck it on the top, and how easy was that to get an elegant look adding a simple piece of beautiful bezel?